Hi, and welcome to another installment of On the Bench. Peter Indrigo of Unitron is here to show us the proper way to focus a stereo microscope using the Unitron Z10 series.
Hi, my name is Peter Indrigo. Today I'm going to talk about the proper setup of a stereo microscope. Today we'll be using the Unitron Z6 common main objective stereo. And this particular stereo is equipped with an ergonomic head, which simply means that we can adjust the eyepieces to many different angles and different heights for different users. When we look at the stereo, we see the eyepieces and the objective. These two need to work in concert with one another. When we go to the microscope, the first thing we want to do is take a look at the diopter settings. And we want to set them to zero. This basically will set the eyepiece up for somebody with perfect vision, where they have no astigmatism or any other aberration in their eyesight. When we go to the microscope, we want to put our eyes approximately 10 millimeters away from the eyepiece top lens, and we want to have a specimen imaged so that we see one image. And that's to get the proper interpupillary distance. The light that comes through the center of these eyepieces matches the retinas in your eyes. Right now I have this set for my eyesight, which basically means I've taken two images and made them one image. Once that's set, this stereo has a zoom range, and we want to take this to its highest magnification point. And at that point, we go to our focus. We close our right eye and get a good sharp focus with our left eye. We now open our right eye, and if it's not sharp, we can adjust that diopter. Once that's set for your eyesight, when you come to this instrument, it could be set at that point and will be properly stated for your eyesight. Now, because we've set this at the high magnification, when we zoom down, the image will remain in focus. That's called parfocality. If we did it the other way, from low power to high power, would not remain in focus. So the proper way is always to have the zoom knob at high power, get your image into sharp focus, and then it will remain parfocal through the zoom range. That's the proper way to adjust the stereo microscope.